So in this video, we are going to learn the fifth and the last rule of identifying significant figures. So the fifth rule says leading zeros in a decimal or a non-decimal number are not significant. Means we do not have to count them as significant figures. So let's study that with an example. I'll be taking one example of a decimal number and one example of a non-decimal number. Supposingly, let's take one number which is a very famous number. If I write a number 007, in this number, these two zeros are considered as the leading zeros. Leading zero means the zero that is before the number, and that zero is not significant. So this particular number will have only one significant figure, that is 7. So this has one significant figure. I take another example. I write a number 0151. In this number also, there is one zero which is a leading zero, that is the number before the zero before a number, and that will be considered as not significant, and this number will have three significant figures. In case of decimal, if I'm writing a number 0.004, this has three numbers, three zeros, which are the leading zeros, and they are again not significant. That's why this particular number will have only one significant figure. In another example, if I write a number 0.012, there are two zeros which are the leading zeros, and again they will be considered as not significant, and that's why this number will have only two significant figures. So this is what the rule number 5, the last rule of significant figure, says, that in a decimal and a non-decimal number, if there are zeros before a number, we call them as a leading zero, and those leading zeros, we do not have to count them while counting the significant figures in a number. Now, in so far these series of 5 videos, we have learnt about 5 rules of significant figures. But the real challenge is to apply these rules while we are doing the rounding of a particular number to a given significant figure as per the question. So if we are doing that, how are we going to apply these 5 rules in rounding of significant figures is what we will be learning in a few more videos that I'm going to post later, okay? And in that, I'm going to pick and choose some questions from the past papers of IGCSE Mathematics, and I'm going to go ahead with those questions and their explanations of how do we apply the 5 rules of significant figures in rounding those numbers. So stay tuned to my channel for further videos and further learning.